think about your morning routine. Wake up, brush your teeth, and maybe even make a cup of coffee. Even though we all have something that we might do differently in the morning, the one thing we all have in common is the water we use coming out of our tap. Now imagine that there was something in that water that could make you really sick, and whatever this thing was had no taste, no smell, or could be seen. Could not be seen. It's kind of scary to think about, and it's a reality facing some communities today due to a phenomenon called cyanobacterial blooms. Cyanobacteria need two things to form, sufficient warmth and nutrients. When these two things are available in a water body, cyanobacteria populations grow and accumulate to create this gunky green substance you see over there. In addition to looking really gross and also having adverse environmental effects, cyanobacteria also have the capabilities to produce toxins called cyanotoxins. When exposed to cyanotoxins, side effects may include adverse effects to the liver and neurological functions, as well as skin irritation, vomiting, diarrhea, and in some cases, even be fatal. Drinking water treatment plants do have the capability to remove some of these cyanotoxins under regular operation. However, for complete removal, changes are often required. These changes can be very difficult to implement because cyanobacteria blooms are very variable in the way that they form, meaning that different species may be present, which means that the type of cyanotoxin and the rate that they're being produced at is also highly variable and difficult to predict. Therefore, if we want to stop these cyanotoxins from entering our water supply, we should try to stop these blooms from occurring in the first place, which means either one, controlling the temperature, which is impossible because you can't control the sun yet, or two, controlling the nutrients, such as phosphorus, which is where my research comes in. What I propose to do is to create an isolated environment called the liminal corral as an impermeable sleeve and insert it within a drinking water reservoir located in Alberta. I'm going to add phosphorus into this liminal corral until I trigger a cyanobacteria bloom to occur. This will become an isolated environment for the cyanobacteria to grow and produce toxins without risk of it entering the water supply. You may be thinking, well, why is this research significant? A lot of research has been done at looking at how nutrient availability occurs in lakes. And a lot of research has also been done on looking at how to treat these cyanotoxins within drinking water treatment plants. However, very little work has been done on seeing how these interactions may change when we're looking at an engineered system, such as the drinking water reservoir. This project is special because it is on the interface of biology and engineering. Therefore, I think it is important because cyanobacterial blooms are an emerging and urgent issue. If we want to make sure that our water supplies stay safe and have no cyanotoxins in it, research like mine is going to be essential for the future. If we want to make sure, then, that we never have to second-guess the water's coming out of our tap, then we need to make sure that we know as much as we can about these cyanobacteria blooms. Thank you.